Today, we'll show off some recent highlights from our recent winter pep rally.
Plus, we'll give out some helpful hints and info about the FAFSA program.
These stories and more, it all starts now on The Current OC.
From OC TV,
Raider Nation's leading news magazine starts now. This is Current OC.
Hello, and welcome to The Current OC. I'm Elijah Watson.
And I'm Madison Dwyer. Happy Groundhog Day. Eli, what's your thoughts on this yearly tradition?
You know, I don't really like it. Phil has seen his shadow for 3 years in a row, and I really don't want 6 more weeks of winter, but who believes in all that hogwash anyways, right?
Good point, but let's check it out. Thousands of fans up early this morning, waiting for Phil to wake up. Did you know it's just about a 5.5-hour ride from Ocean City across Pennsylvania to get to Punxsutawney? Maybe you can go next year and get a cool groundhog hat.
Sure, I'll let you know how that turns out, but good news from Gobbler's Globe, Phil did not see his shadow. So an early spring is on the way, and hopefully now the weather will warm up and we can go back to the beach.
Coming up later in the show, we'll get a real scoop from our weather expert, Kuba. Hopefully he didn't see his shadow.
Now that we have that settled, tell me about some helpful tips with this new college financial aid program.
With college just around the corner, something that a lot of students and parents alike struggle with is figuring out the new FAFSA program. If you're someone who's trying to figure out the process, or maybe you don't even know what it is, we have Kaylin Barron to help you give the answers that you're looking for.
Geez, this FAFSA thing, it is so annoying. If only there's just someone here to help me.
The free application for federal student aid, also known as FAFSA, has just opened this January. Although FAFSA might seem like a bunch of random letters, it is very vital for our seniors, especially when applying for college. Here at The Current OC, we interview Ms. O to find out what it's really about.
Who are you?
What is FAFSA and why is it important for me as a student?
What is the FAFSA and why is it important? The FAFSA is the free application for federal student aid. Every senior that's planning on going to college next year, whether it's a 2-year, 4-year, or trade technical school, should be filing the FAFSA. It is a free application that students currently have access to. This year in particular has been a little bit of a bumpy road. We've had a later application open, as well as a soft launch, which has caused a lot of issues for students and families. Therefore, we're encouraging students to come down to the College and Career Center to get support with filing their FAFSA. It is the only way that students know if they qualify for financial aid for colleges and universities.
How do I determine if I am eligible for federal student aid through FAFSA?
The FAFSA itself has questions as well as a retrieval tool to get your family's financial information into the actual application itself. Therefore, you are not determining whether you're aid eligible. The federal government, as well as the state of New Jersey and or your college or university, will determine whether or not you're eligible for financial aid.
When is the FAFSA deadline and how should I be prepared in advance?
So the free application for federal student aid deadline is not a hard and fast deadline this year. As I mentioned earlier, it's been a bumpy road because the FAFSA is completely new and different this year. So for the class of 2024, they will likely have later deadlines. However, that doesn't mean you should wait to file the FAFSA. Students should be filing the FAFSA if they're a senior in high school now. And they also want to check with their college or university or their trade technical school in terms of when the college, university, or school requires the actual FAFSA.
What information and documents do I need to complete the FAFSA application?
Actually, most of the financial aid application can be found online. If your parent guardian that is filing the FAFSA with you does not file their taxes online, they would need all of their tax information as well as your tax information prior to filing the FAFSA.
Thanks, random person just materialized right next to me.
You're welcome, John. This has been Kaylin Barron reporting from The Current OC.
Wait, where'd she go? How did she know my name? Wait, what?
Thanks, Kaylin. But now it's time to hop, skip, and jump into our recent winter pep rally. And you can trust The Current OC got all the angles of all the action. So let's get into it.
Yeah. Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Rainy, windy, yes, it's that time of the year for a delicious cup of soup. January was National Soup Month, and to recognize that, where better to go than our very own cafeteria? We worked with our very special cafeteria ladies to get the secret behind the tastiest soup in town. Here's Scarlett Fletcher and Allie Hudson.
Hey, Allie.
Hey, Scarlett.
Have you heard about the soups here at OCHS?
No, I haven't.
OCHS has Miss Smith cooking up the daily soups for the students and staff to enjoy. What's a better time to come down here and try them than National Soup Month?
Gretchen kills the soup every day. The soup is incredible, no matter what it is. French onion, great choice here.
Delicious.
French onion, let's get in there.
I like a clam chowder and the tomato basil.
Gretchen, she loves making soup. She loves pleasing all the staff and the students, and it's just made with love.
Gretchen's tender love and care, homemade daily.
It's a 10. Students can find the menu posted daily in the cafeteria. These soups are made from scratch.
Need to save room for croutons. I'm taking two.
Reporting from the current OC.
Happy National Soup Month.
Great stuff from Mrs. Smith's kitchen. Now to a little known event in OC hosted by English teacher Jenna Scioli that gives students an opportunity to show off their talents. Ocean City Literary Magazine and the Tri-M Music Honor Society held an open mic night at Glazed Over on Asbury. The night was full of painting, drawing, singing, and even some poetry readings. People painted on ceramics supplied by the store, drew on the tables, sang heartfelt songs, and read some of their very original poetry work. Thank you, Mrs. Scioli, for making this such a great event for us, and Glazed Over for being an amazing host. Look out for the newest edition of the Speakeasy Magazine coming out in the spring, and we hope to see you at the next open mic.
That looked like a great event.
It sure did. Now, let's see what DJ Sports has cooking with sports.
Hey, thanks, guys. We're starting off today on the mats with the boys and girls wrestling. Coach Calhoun and his Red Raiders have been rolling through a successful regular season with their eyes on AC, the site of state championships. Here's Logan Smith with the insight of this year's squad.
The OC wrestling team has had a hot start to the season with an 8-2 record. They are second in the Cal.
What are you looking forward to this season?
I'm looking forward to winning more matches and hopefully going to regions.
Win a state championship.
I'm looking forward to see how our team does in the team playoffs and the postseason.
What is your favorite part of the team?
Favorite part, I'd say it's these group of guys right here. Everyone here putting that work in.
Leading the way are senior captains Nick Layton and Aiden Leipold, along with Talon Fisher. What's been the key to the hot start of the season?
Staying focused, doing what coaches says, and winning the matches that need to be won.
I think it's just when we go outside, we have to run really fast and hard, and you know that gets our conditioning good. And when we have better conditioning than the other teams, we win every time.
What is your favorite move?
Can I show you what it is?
Sure.
Oh, yeah, Clarence, come here.
Some call it a splay, I like to call it the banana split. Here we go. You got a leg in here? You got a leg in here? You got a bogey.
Pop it up.
And then, you know, then you got to squeeze. Hey, don't let it. It's a pit, baby.
That's it from wrestling. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Logan. Now to hoops. The boys basketball took down crosstown rivals Mainland in one of the biggest matchups of the year earlier this week. Let's go to the highlights. A packed house for this showdown of top teams. As expected, it's a back-and-forth battle. The Red Raiders took control and never looked back. Dylan Schroeder leads the way with 21 points. Charlie Labar and Corey Segich adding 11 each. OC wins 59-52 as Segich seals it with a slam. The Red Raiders are now 18-2 on the season. And in the upcoming Cal tournament, OC is the number 2 seed behind Middle Township. That's all with sports. Back to you guys.
Thanks, DJ. But it's time to switch gears to weather.
So, Eli, did Kuba see his shadow, or is he calling for an early spring?
Well, I don't know. Let's find out. Hey, Kuba, what kind of weather are we expecting for this upcoming season?
Well, as you know, the groundhog whose name I cannot pronounce did not see a shadow, which means that we're going to get an early spring somehow. Let's see if his prediction is right. Looking at our current temperature, we can see that it is 43 degrees outside. You know, this time of weather from January to March, it is honestly pretty miserable. Let's just look at our regional temperatures and see how they compare. Wow, those are also all mid to low 40s, except of course Baltimore at 49, which I don't even know why we have Baltimore on this map. It's an entirely different city. It's like we had Shanghai on there. It's 41 degrees there, by the way. Let's go back to Ocean City. What's it known for? That's right, it's a city on the ocean. That means it has tides. We just hit our high tide a few minutes ago, actually. It's about 1 p.m. right now. And our low tide is at 7, which is approximately when all those theater kids get home from school after all their work. Our 7-day forecast, you can see that it is 40s all throughout. It's a pretty sunny weekend, but it is still pretty, like, miserable temperatures, I would say. So it might rain on Friday.
Interesting dig at theater kids, but what are your thoughts on Punxsutawney Phil?
I would recommend him to change his name, but looking on my own, I suggest he just keeps it for
That's
now.
A good point. Well, it's that time. Let's see another fabulously fantastic fanatic, Fast Five. This time featuring the ever-amazing teacher, Mr. Clark. Here's Kira Riley.
Today, we are here with Mr. Clark to ask him Fast Five questions. So tell me, what is your biggest pet peeve?
My biggest pet peeve is people who are lazy. I don't like lazy people.
How long have you worked here?
I worked here for 24 years, I think it is, about there.
What is your favorite place you've ever visited?
Favorite place I've ever visited is probably Costa Rica. Beautiful, beautiful location.
Who is your favorite U.S. president?
That is easy. It's James K. Polk. He's the inventor of the mullet.
And what is your favorite film of all time?
My favorite film of all time is Jaws. Jaws is the greatest movie of all time ever made.
Agreed, it's classic.
Awesome.
This has been Kira Riley reporting for The Kern OC.
Well, that'll do it for us on this edition of The Kern OC.
Remember to log on and catch all of our shows and additional content by visiting oc-tv.org.
And be sure to like and follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and X at OCNJTV.
Thanks for watching. We leave you now with some highlights from our Broadway night from the inside of Hughes Performing Arts Center.
And no, there are things you must not say. Discretion is the only way that love survives.
Break the lock, post my bail. Done my time, I'm out of jail. Not for the life of me. Do you think the wizard is dumb? Or like Munchkin, so small-minded? No, he'll say to me, I see who you truly are. A girl.
Sometimes I'm down, sometimes I'm up, but he follows round like some droopy-eyed
Top.